In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in His consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
From the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and everyone that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains in the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Tita Linda is here.
Tita Linda. Last Sunday, ito yung gospel.
The same, huh? Yeah. I am the vine, you are the branches. So.
Yeah.
Tita Lynn, for the three pointers.
One moment, ha. Tinamal ang internet namin. Today's three pointers, number one. Today is Labor Day. We honor Saint Joseph, the patron saint of workers, a humble carpenter and Jesus' foster father. Number two, as Christians, we must not be critical of our relatives and neighbors, nor allow familiarity to breed contempt, especially when they are a humble backgrounds. They are of humble backgrounds, poor or less capable than us. Number three, when we treat others, particularly the poor and marginalized, with dignity and show them kindness and compassion, we bring Christ's love and light to them. This is what Jesus commands us to do. Will you do it for him? Amen.
Amen. Amen. So today's gospel, no, as Tito Manny said, no, na today's gospel is about the true divine, no, the vine and the I am the vine and you are the branches, no, just like last Sunday's gospel. And then today we honor the Saint Joseph the carpenter, no, the feast of Saint Joseph. So I'm going to read to you the Haro Cathedral Media, no, about Saint Joseph, no, and then the rest can have their reflections on the branches, the vine and the branches, no. It says here, Joseph taught God to do carpentry. Nothing could be done through just mere words. Learn to love your work. Ito, learn to love your work, no matter what it is, no. It is only in so doing that you'll have a lot of energy to enjoy every minute of it. Oftentimes, most of your fatigue comes from exerting too much energy on a job contrary to your likes. It matters much when you are in love with your work. Excellence can only happen when your mind is in accord with what your hands can accomplish. It generates gratefulness in retrospect to what your skills can do that boasts your esteem. God provides you with deserving talents to prove your worth according to the level of your capacity. He even let himself to grow and be molded by a happy carpenter who loved his work and who later on came out as one of the famous persons in our history. Never underestimate yourself. God does not see your success, but how you strive to be worthy of what he has given you to sustain your fitness. Every endeavor passes through the pains of labor. And it says here, bless me and my works, O Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So
Amen.
This work, no, it's not only the work, no, the job. Well, of course, the job that we have, but also the work as a mother, as a father, as an uncle, as an aunt, as a daughter, as a son, as a brother, as a sister, as a Christian, as a neighbor. Yun ang works na binibigay sa atin, no. It says here, do the best you can, whatever work it is given to you. Do the best you can. Love your work, whatever it is. Be you know, be the boss, or you know, no matter what is the work that you have, or you were given, love it. Because according to our Haro Cathedral Media here, no, Joseph, a carpenter, no, simple life, but Jesus, the Son of God, have learned a lot from his human father, who is Saint Joseph. So today is Saint Joseph the carpenter, patron saint of the laborer. We will pray for Saint Joseph as the son of as the father, the human father of Jesus Christ, the righteous, this righteous Saint Joseph, the chaste Saint Joseph, the simple Saint Joseph, and the head of the Holy Family. Amen.
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 So in today's gospel, we ask, no, why the example of grapevine, no? Bakit kaya hindi ibang vine dyan? No, bakit grapes? Yun ang naano ko, kay tapos
yun kasi ang mga major plantation sa area, yes, na yun.
During that time. And then it symbolizes doon sa kanila during biblical time, no, the vine is the symbol of the children of Abraham. Yun ang gina-example ni Jesus, because that's the most common. Yun ang kilala ng mga tao during that time. Kaya ang ano na Christians who follow the Jewish faith, they become the grapevine, which is valid and being respected during that time, biblical time.
Okay, here's the reflection. Yeah. How does it feel without connection to the internet? It seems that something important in our lives is lacking. We cannot function properly if our job is reliant on the internet. Somehow our lives now is associated with the internet, be it Wi-Fi or cable-based internet connection. When we are outside of our respective houses, our smartphones are ever ready to find Wi-Fi connection. We look for it because we need or we want to be connected. How about our desire to be connected with Jesus and God? Do we always seek a connection with Jesus and God? Is our desire for Jesus and God as intense as our desire for a Wi-Fi or internet connection? In today's gospel, Jesus tells us that he is the vine and we are the branches. And as such, we must always be connected with him and God. Life without connection with God is meaningless. Even if we have all the material wealth and power, it's still meaningless without God. If only we would always desire connection with God more than we desire Wi-Fi or internet connection. If only we would invest more time with God as much as we invest time using our smartphones, computers, and laptops. Let us therefore always seek connection with God through our prayers, presence at Holy Mass, and by reading and reflecting upon his life, transforming words in the Bible. The best is yet to come for us if we would seek permanent connection with our vine and our vine grower, no other than Jesus and God. Amen. Marino das Marino.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Walang bayad yun. Libre. Saan ka pa? Yeah. Kaya kung i-compare natin, tama nga naman, internet. Nawawala-wala nga. Humihina yung signal dahil sa daming subscribers. Pero pag nakakonect ka nga naman kay Jesus at kay and his Father God, no problem. Probably all your problems will be solved. But it's not that simple. See? It may be free, but you need to do something with your life. No? Hindi ibig sabihin nakakonect ka, eh, okay na. Hanggang doon na lang. No? It says here, you will be pruned. And pruning hurts, as I have said before. Pruning hurts. Masasaktan ka talaga, masakit yun eh. Gawa ng... You will have to let go of your vices, everything, you know? Mga masasamang gawin. Mga kung ano-ano dyan. Kaya it's not very easy to let go of all these things. We've been at it since our childhood, since we were young. So it's not easy to just let go or remove this. But it is a requirement. To have a what is a good connection. Okay, amen.
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 Thank you very much, Tito Manisno. So we need this connection with God all the time, every moment of our life. Do you have something to say, Belle, or anybody?
Yeah,
no. I'm at Tita Helen, meron ka?
Yeah, here in 366 days. Action. He prunes so that it bears more fruit. The quality of the fruit of the vine and of the wine that is pressed from it depends in many ways on the original stock of the mother vine. But much of the harvest depends on the caretaker of the vineyard. Jesus alludes to himself, the true vine, and to God the Father as the ultimate vine dresser. Israel, and later the Christian community, is God's vineyard. Course of the believer's existence, pruning is necessary to allow buds of grapes to flourish by allowing the excess sap to nourish the emerging fruits rather than the extra leaves. Pruning, which involves cutting, is the metaphor of suffering, just as the suffering of Jesus on the cross offers life to human beings, so also the suffering of the believers, united that of Jesus, he is life-giving both to the sufferer and to others. St. Paul writes, I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ on behalf of his body, which is the church. Moreover, the discipline of pruning may seem a cause for pain, yet later it brings the peaceful fruit of righteousness. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Helen. Very true, no? We are pruned in order for us to bear more fruits, no? We will be pruned. I would like to repeat this again and again, no, that I, you know, during the pandemic, but we were all pruned, no? We were all pruned during the pandemic, no? I don't have to elaborate everything, no? Pero nag-change ang lifestyle natin. Na-cut off tayo from so many, many, many things, no? that we owned, that we used to have, we used to do, no? We were being pruned, all of us, everybody, in order to bear fruits. So the outcome of this pandemic have a very, very positive outcome. People became more prayerful, people became more faithful, people became more aware of God during the pandemic time, no? Kasi we were in a situation when everything was unpredictable and was not certain ba. So what the people did, no? Nag-cling sa faith natin, nag-cling sa faith natin, nag-become prayerful, and we trust God. Wala na tayong maano na iba. Only God during that time. And so this ministry was born also. So we were pruned, no? Mga worldly possessions natin, whatever it was or whatever they were, no? We were pruned and then to bear more fruits. So I'm going to read to you one paragraph, no, from this Catholic Daily Reflections, no? The fruit that God wants to produce also takes place within your soul, ito, in the form of the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Yan. The fruits of the Holy Spirit. These fruits consist of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Each one of these gifts from God will have the effect of transforming you more fully into an image of God Himself in our world. So when we have these gifts of the Holy Spirit, no, we become more godly, no, because we were created, no, in the image and likeness of God. So try to take a moment to consider each one of those fruits of the Holy Spirit. Each one is very desirable. Growing in a desire for them will help you grow in a desire for the Holy Spirit in your life. So reflect today upon the beautiful and meaningful image given to us by Jesus of the vine and the branches. Think of a vine and then think of yourself firmly attached to that vine. Sit with that image prayerfully and let God speak to you. He wants to do great things in you and through you. If you will only cling to Him with all your heart, an abundance of good fruit will be produced. Amen.
Amen.
So it explains, no, now we cannot do anything without God. We cannot do anything without God. So
apart from Him, we are nothing.
Yeah. We are nothing without Him. Without Him, we are nothing. So that's a good lesson, no, of today's gospel, no? Jesus is our vine. I mean, Jesus is a grapevine and we are the branches. So if we cling to him, if we remain in that mother vine, no, we will become fruitful. So we ask ourselves, are we fruitful enough? No? During this stage of our life, no? During this stage of our life, are we fruitful enough?
We need to be prone in order to be fruitful.
Yeah.
Trying
So that's our everyday aim, everyday goal, everyday struggle and challenges, no? To remain in him and to bear fruit, not only for our families, but for others, especially the marginalized, the last, the lost, and the, ano nga, Tita Bell?
The least, the last, and the lost.
Amen.
Amen.
Maybe this. Maybe we're going to have the closing prayer. No. Any other? Any next? Do you have anything?
Well, not dun.
Okay na. Sige. Yeah.
Thank you.
Miga Belen.
Okay. Yes. Almighty God, thank you for giving us a good health and enabling us to come to this prayer gathering to glorify your name. Thank you for your words, for it always comfort our hearts and full of hope and contentment. Help us to refrain from things that will steal our peace and joy. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray. Amen.
Amen. And all together, please. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Love you guys. Take care.